Okay, I finished doing a lot of the decorating inside the journal. The first section of the journal. I haven't done the second one, but I wanted to show you where we were at the first. I showed you how to make the pockets, and now I was filling up the pockets with different things. You can put your mother's recipes in there, your just anything. You could make this as a liquor, a drink type of recipe book. But mine is this one here is specially made for, oh, I would say kitchen, women in the kitchen, in the household, period. Any of you are interested in any of these images, because everything I'm using in here is from the shop Retro Sass Design from Etsy. So feel free to go on her site. She has tons of retro tags, cards, recipe cards, you name it, paper, you name it, she has it. So anyway, a quick shot. This is the first page. I filled it up with plenty of room to write, journaling cards, tags. the same thing over here. I've added some tags, a recipe. I just kind of added a few things here, a ribbon, a piece of fabric for texture, textile, a bowl, a little bit of rickrack, and a can of Spam and a beef and sugar crisp with some fabric. And again, I've added, you know, more of the same here. Not the same recipes, but the same thing. I've added some paper, a little bit of a tag here with an old stove, picture of the Honey Graham. And here you can write some more right in the back of this recipe card, or right there, citrus here, frost beverage. And here's a Coconut Delight Pina Colada, and charging up here. And I added a bit of Bob or whatever, little Bob's here. And Jill's girls want to have fun. In the back, I am woman, see me shop. And here, a morning without coffee is like sleep, because you can't wake up. Please go fascinate someone else. I mean, her cards are really, really fun. And here is another one that I've kind of dressed up this way. And another one here, which is pineapple cream cheese pie, places to write, places to journal, tags to put your thoughts on. Here is another one that I just put the old radios on. And here's a Pyrex bowl. You can put a thought or two in here. Again, you can write a recipe, or you can write a recipe or thoughts or whatever. And on that page too, same thing. On this side is a cute little telephone bell card. And here I did the same thing. I added just a piece of ribbon and a pirate's bowl and some soft to stick. A little cake on the back here. And here is my reality check bounced. And, you know, just to write your thoughts and your... It's a journal. So, you know, you can do whatever you want. Here's a nice little retro card. Here's a nice little coffee can, those plastic pink coffee cans we used to have. Here's a nice little apron there. And on this one here, dinner is poured. Be reasonable, do it my way. Here's buttonware. I think we used to call that Melmine in our days. I'm not quite sure but about that. But anyway, and here there's three pockets in this one that I showed you how to make. And there's the old-fashioned macaroni and cheese, a boldly going nowheres. And another little idea card, a recipe card you can write on top. You can write in here somewheres. And there's another little lady in the kitchen, per se. Recipe, buttonware again. And here, I take life with a grain of salt, a wedge of lime, and a shot of tequila. And here's your thoughts. And then you can write again here. I just added a little card. A little Melmine bowl here, and a can of beef. I love these pictures. They just go back in time. I love that. I left it as is. And then going bold, nowheres. And no, we're not doing this attitude, because this is what it's all about, sassy little journal. And a pot, and a milk, and retro again. And being reasonable, do it my way. A Woman's Place is in the mall. And here's a nice little Born to be Wild, a nice little apron-looking card to write a recipe. And then don't hold back, charge. And in the back, as I had showed you how to make these little vellum envelopes, and I have a couple of journal cards there. So this is the beginning. I am going to decorate the next one, and I'll be back. And after we're done these, I think we'll probably start working on the cover. We will be back. Alrighty, so I showed you how I did this one. And now I'm done this one. So this is how the other one I did. Pretty much the same way. Added some, tags and whatnot. Lots and lots of journaling and sayings. We'll have that cocktail now. And the other one says, why limit it to happy hour? And then this other one here says, I'll rise, but I refuse to shine. I think that is so cute. And then this one I just added, there was a journal tuck right there, so I added one here and another one here. I'll take life with a grain of salt, a wedge of lime, and a shot of tequila. I may throw something, a recipe in there after, there's room. And I, on the doily, I added a retro here, a little tag to put a little thought or something, just I glued a little apron here and a little soft silk cake flower thing. And a little journaling card in this one. I'm feeling a little bit overworked and under intoxicated. And here it says, I don't have time to be this busy. I thought that was cute. And a little journaling card. And another one here. I'll take life with a grain of salt. And another one here. I just realized that I have two like that. I might take this out and add a, don't like to repeat so too much, so I think I'll take that one out and I will put a recipe card in here. This one here is just an idea card, just making it up as I go along, cute little journal tag, and another one here with a recipe, and that you can write in the back also, and here on the little card I just added a little cake, put a little tab, a little couple of decoupage right here. And here I added a retro card for the corner tuck. As you remember, I added a tag, be reasonable, do it my way, and another real cute one that says boldly going nowheres. I think that is so cute for a little recipe card. So I thought that was cute. And as the other one, I just left that plain. I do like that. Lots of journaling spaces because I said so. I'll rise, but I refuse to shine, and a retro card for this one, too. And I really like that. Oops, I'll put this one in the back here. And, this is my choice. You can kind of make it all up the way you like it. There's always days that I'm so busy that I don't get anything done as a journal card, a little bit of retro here for just a little card for journaling, and another little tuck one here. On this one here, I added, it's not my nagging if you're always right. And inside, I just added a little Pyrex bowls and so forth. And again, here too, inside, a few of the spam and so forth. And a little apron, retro card here. On the back here, there's another one here that says, there are days that I'm so busy I don't get anything done. Inside I have a few tags again, and they're all ready to write on the back. Be reasonable, do it my way. And then the other one says, my reality check bounced. And another little tag there. You can write on the bottom here, a little apron, a couple of little Pyrex bowls here. Beautiful layout there. And again, on this little tuck card, I just added a little notation that you can put and hide away. And here I have a retro card, another little tech card with a Pyrex bowl and a box of rice with a little tag and a mix master. Here is a couple of ladies blowing up a cake, and it says, boldly going nowheres, I'll ride but I refuse to shine again, a thought, and a recipe card. A recipe, I should say, not a recipe card. And if you turn it again, when life hands you lemons, grab tequila and call me over. And here's a sass card And here's another little card that says, well, this day was a total waste of makeup. And a little card for journaling thoughts and to write your recipe or your thoughts, whichever one. This little one says retro. And on the back, you have a can of pancake mix, a box, a little sassy with a typewriter here. I don't have time to be this busy, pardon me, on the other side of the doily. On this page, I have a little journaling card, my reality check bounce, and next time, my mood swing is in 6 minutes. And some lust aware, and in the back, it says, please go fascinate someone else, telephone, retro, ideas, and so forth. She has so many that I've only have a few here. So if you look at her Etsy shop, if this is something that you enjoy, do go to Retro Sass Design Shop, because she has so many different things and recipes and so forth that you can fulfill whatever you want. This is going to be the size of my journal, guys. I'm going to make a cover now, and we are going to work together and show you how I will make a journal cover to add to this journal. So stay with me, because we're going to be right back. Okay, guys, we're going to start on the cover, but there's a couple of things I'd like to go through before. How I measure my cover to know how thick I need the back of the binding is you normally take the book like this, and I'll just make a rough measurement without having it squished there, just a rough measurement. And this one here at the widest part. So at this one here, it's about 2 inches. So what I did is I ended up taking some chipboard. You can take a box of cereal if you like. Any cardboard that is thick enough to hold the book together. And I have cut 2 pieces. And as you remember, 2 pieces here, but if you remember, this here is 5 1/4 by 5 1/4 by 8 1/2. So what I did is I cut a piece I took a piece of chipboard, which was 12 by 12. I cut it in half at 6 inches. But really, if you're just working with regular cardboard, put it about 1/4 inch longer than what your book is. So if your book is 5 1/4, go 5 3/4 instead of 6 inches. I am probably going to end up taking 1/4 inch off of that. I cut 2 pieces of that. Okay, so you're looking at 2 pieces of cardstock, of chipboard, which measures here 5 3/4 and by 8 3/4. Let me rephrase that. 11 by 8 1/2. That's 5 3/4 by. All right, so we're ready to start the cover on this journal, and I'm going to show you how I get an idea of how thick I want this journal. So this journal at this point is, I take a ruler, any ruler really, and I do an approximate width. So here I see it's about 2 inches at its larger part. So what I did is I took a piece of a chipboard. My chipboard was 12 by 12. So I cut it out in 3 pieces. One is, you're going to need a piece that goes 5 3/4 across, because your paper here is 5 1/2. So you like to go 1/4 inch longer. And here it is 8 1/2. So I cut it down at 8 3/4. So my book will fit into the journal and have a bit of give on each side. You can cut it exactly if you like. What happens is that you have pages sticking out, and I'm not sure. Well, that's not what I want. Let's put it this way. Because there's really no wrongdoing. It just depends how you like it. Now, so I've cut 2 pieces of that. My front, my back. This is going to be my spine. So as I said, I measured it. It had 2 inches approximately. So I cut a piece of, on 2 inches here and the same length here at 8 3/4, up and down, okay? Now, when you get to put this together to form a book, what happens, you don't have to use gymboard too. You can use cereal boxes, shoe boxes, it doesn't matter what it is. As long as it's a hard, a decently hard cardboard. My gymboard is not that thick, as you can tell, but it doesn't have any ply to it. There are thicker, there are thinner ones. This is what I just grabbed on my shelf here. So, another thing that would be handy if you had would be either some type of duct tape, which doesn't rip, or in this case, this is roofing they put underneath the membrane, so you can't rip it. There's no holes in it or anything, and there's a reason for that. Is you want to enforce the crease, because you're going to be open it, close it. If you have a piece of cardboard or a piece of paper, it won't last. So you need to have something that can take some wear and tear on it. So this is what we have right here. Now, another thing that I have that I would suggest to you is either get a really, really strong glue, like E6000, for an example, or some good two-way score tape glue. It's important because you don't want your book to start falling apart. So this is what we are going to start by doing. Now, I normally leave just a little gap, let's say about an eighth. I don't know how long that would be. I never measured it. I just eyeballed it normally. But it's not a quarter of an inch. It's about an eighth of an inch, I would say, to give it room to be able to ply. If you don't do that, if it's tight like this, what happens is it's going to be too tight. Your book is going to want to not going to open properly. So you leave it open about a quarter of an inch. So the first thing I'm going to do, and you don't need to have your Tyvek type of material that size. I particularly like that size, but you don't particularly need to have it that size. Tyvek is something they wrap the homes with also, and it's just something that's very tough, very, very tough. Always make sure that your adhesive, some people even take their bone folder and run it over it. And that's not a bad thing, because it'll hold your glue really down really well. Now, you don't have to have this wide of tape. You can just use the quarter inch if you want. I just grabbed that. It was the first thing that was on my thing. So, like this. So you have two pieces of tape, okay? You're going to put these about, like I said earlier, about an eighth of an inch apart, like so. And you're going to try as much as possible to make sure that they are level on the top, like this. Because if they are level, and like this, oops, then you have no issue. You won't have a side that is not as, there, just like that. It's no great big science, just put it down. It doesn't have to be totally, totally exact. And don't worry if your tape is showing a little bit, because we're going to cover this particular, it's going to go on crooked. We are going to cover this. Let me see if this is not easier if I do it this way. And then on the back side, I can see a little better. Can you see what I'm doing here? I've done enough of them that I should, see? So now when I close it, it just, like a real book, it'll fold, it won't hold tight and stuff. Okay, so now I'm going to do the other side and I'm going to prepare for the next step. So please stay tuned. Okay, so now I have the tape on both sides that reinforces my book. As you can tell, see how it's starting to form. It already looks like a book. So now what I'm going to do, what we need to do, is we need to make holes in the binding in the back, in this part here, in the spine. We need to make the holes to match with this to run in here. Now you can do this different ways. I've already bind the book, so that's ready to go. You can make a spine inside that will hold this book intact, or we can rethread the inside going through this part and coming across. That'll be double threading it. And I normally do them before I dress it up, put them in the book, thread my signatures, and I dress them in this way. But on this case, I did them opposite. I threaded the signature, both dressed up. Now I'm going to put them in a book. So this is a totally first time for me, but I know that it really, it's going to be the same thing. If anything at all, it will reinforce the signature. So the way I do this is you have your spine right here. We know that the spine, we need to add two signatures. So we know the spine is 2 inches, right? So 2 inches is 1 inch is the center of the spine. Now we need to go across this way, and this way we have 8 3/4. So we know that it's 4 4 4 1/4, and 4 1/4, as you guys know your math, is, I can't see the ruler here. Let me grab this one. Okay, let me start again here at, we know that at 8 1/2, it's 4 1/4. And 4 1/4, and we have here 8 3/4. So we're going to go 4 1/4 plus 2. So this is my center of my binding. Do you understand what I mean? I go in the middle, which is 2 inches, and I added a mark. I mean, I could have just coincidence that I had it right on, but I could have had it differently. Then I go across this way, which is 8 3/4. So 8 3/4 is 4 1/4. 4 1/4 and 4 1/4 is 8 1/2 plus 2 for easy math. Okay, instead of going 7/16 and so blah, 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 I do it this way. I find that most of us find it easier to go that way. So now that I have this, I know this is my center point. So this is where the center hole on my on my signature will be set in the middle here, but not there. I need to add 1/2 inch in the middle of that inch. I need to add and 1/2 inch there. So at 1/2 inch here, once I found my center on my spine, I go 1/2 inch here and 1/2 inch here, which is the same. That'll bring me right to the middle of my spine, because we're going to have to make holes here. So that's what I'm looking for right there. Now we know this is the center. So from the center here to the following hole is 2 inches. So all I need to do at this point is go 2 inches, 2 inches here, and then I go 2 inches there, and I do the same thing here. So if I measure it here and I go 2 inch this way here and 2 inches here, that should make my spine straight. So I have 6 holes. Do you understand what I did there? So we are automatically canceling these. I mean, I didn't have to wipe them, but we are automatically canceling those. And you're going to put your one signature on one side, all the holes match, and one signature on the other side. And it gives it the exact amount of space between each one. Okay? Now, making the holes. The holes can be made in very many different ways. You can use a pick like this, punch it through, and you have your hole. It went across. You can use a crocodile like this. If you have a long arm crocodile, you can do it. You just measure it to, you just follow your eyes, follow where you have your pencil mark, and there, you have your hole. Your hole is gone right straight through, okay? If you have a scissor, you can take a sharp scissor. You have a sharp scissor, you put your hole through this way. It doesn't matter as long as you put a hole through all of them. And because I have my crocodile here, I find that easy because I enjoy putting some eyelets in mine. And by putting the eyelets in, it just makes it a little cuter. That's the only reason I put the eyelets, because at this point, there's not enough weight, there's not enough on these to, there's not enough stress on these holes to rip them. So it really is okay. Now, before I continue, I'm going to want to put a charm on this. And what I mean by a charm is I'm going to want to have something dangling here. And I normally make a little charm and I'll hook it on and just as a doodad. So, to do this, I am going to go about probably a half an inch down. About a half an inch down, and I want to make a hole in the center. And the reason I am doing it now is that it's a lot easier to do it, because once I have my signatures in, it's going to be hard to fit that in between. But it can be done. It's just a lot easier if you think ahead of time. So now, I have all my holes done, and I am ready to go further. I'm not going to put my eyelets in because the eyelets are, I'm not going to put the eyelets in. This stuff is so tough, guys. Sometimes you have to cut. The holes are made, but it doesn't cut down right straight through here. The reason being is because I want to add my embellishments on top. So let me see what I can find to decorate the top, and I will be right back with you guys. Okay, so now I've printed out the paper that I've wanted, and it's paper that you can get on Retro Sass Design, and I've printed four of those. I am going to attach this to the book frame just like I would be embellishing a gift. So I am going to add some glue to this. I am going to add on this piece here. So all I'm going to do at this point is I'm going to grab some tape. I'm going to add it here. My holes will be easy to find. If you're not comfortable doing the holes beforehand, you can do it later. You can do it after. I just find it easy because I can see exactly where my spine is to make the holes instead of feeling it with my fingers. So I find it quite easy to work that way. But if you prefer, like I said, you can, once you've embellished the whole cover, you can add it afterwards. It'll work. Okay, so there's one. And I'm not going to put my eyelets in before everything is in here. And all I do here is I'm going to add a piece on top here, like this. And another piece here on the edge, and like so, and I am going to add another piece all of the way down, like this. Now, you can glue this. You don't have to use this kind of tape. Just the reason I like to use the tape is because when I'm using paper, if I use liquid glue, you have to be very sparse with it. My experience is that when I put glue, the paper becomes ripple, and I particularly don't like that. Now, if you have cardstock, if you're printing on cardstock, that's a little firmer. The fibers are firmer. Therefore, it probably won't do that. But this is what I have. Now, if you have anything with writing on it, you want to kind of make sure that it's on the right side, just in case it shows. So I know by the top where I'm going to put my bling here, or my draw charm, I know this is the right side up. So I don't necessarily have to be perfectly square on this, but I am doing it as well as I can. And when you get to the other side, you can see that you can wrap it like you do a gift, okay? Just make sure that your spine is nice and smooth, that it's not too tight, because if it's too tight, your paper will rip, okay? So let me get the other side going, and I'll be right back. Okay, as you can see, I've added my paper on both sides. Yes, you can see the white, but we're going to do something with that. And as you can tell, when I went to put it down, I don't know if you can tell that, but this is what happens when you don't pay attention to how you're putting it down. I have a little ripple, but that's okay, because I'm going to be able to fix that. But if you wanted a nice modern finesse, modern look on it, you're going to see the crease. But because I'm doing it vintage, it is going to be fine. Okay, now, what I'm going to show you now is how to do the corners. What I do is, you can do it, you can fold it and then fold it back this way, you know, but we're going to put something inside the cover. It's just to wrap it up like you would a gift, but a gift normally you just bend it one on top of the other like that, but I don't want that bulk, and I don't think you want it either. So I just cut a corner off like this, and I do the same thing on the other side. Just cut off up to about just a smidge before the corner here. Just a smidge. And you're going to do the same thing on four corners. Just a little bit before the edge, like that. And again, over here, like that. Okay, so you don't need these pieces. This is going to become some garbage. Now that I have all my score tape down and snug and ready to go, I'm going to take the tape protector off, like that. I'm going to take all four off. You can do a couple at a time if you wish, if you're afraid that something will stick to it. But I'm going to do it this way. And what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to wrap the paper like this. Wrap it over to make a nice smooth edge on the side. And again here, just tug it a bit. Doesn't matter that it's crooked, because we're going to have something on top of that anyway. Pull, tug, and a pull, and a tug. See how it fits in there properly? And it'll make a nice side. And then just pull and tug a bit to roll it over the sides. And look at the beautiful cover you have. And it's not finished yet. So now what we're going to do is, we're going to need to put a piece on the front of this. In order to do that, you need to take a measurement again. So we know that the measurement across this is going to be a little longer than 12 inches. So if you do not have a full page of something that is at least, you know, that length, it's not going to work. So I printed out 2 more pages of this, because this is what I want as my base. And then I am going to trim all the white off of it with my cutter, and I'm going to set them inside exactly the same way. Let me do my cutting, and let me come back, and I'll explain. Okay, so now I've cut my paper to match. What I did is I cut them at 7 3/4. Okay, what I did is cut them at 7 3/4, and here I did them to fit this at 8. I've already forgotten how long it was. I believe it's 8 3/4. 8 3/4 by 7 1/4. And the reason I did it like that is because I wanted to fit this way, but I do want a bit of an overlap, not a whole lot to make it thick, but in the center, I want a bit of an overlap so it'll look cleaner. Okay, now, before you go on to the next step, take a piercer of some sort, scissors, doesn't matter what, but where, if you do make a hole on the top to put a charm, just put your piercer through so you can see where your holes are. It's a lot easier. You can find them after, but while this is still open here, it's so easy to find there. Okay, so I've done all my piercing. I know exactly where they are. So when I end up putting these pieces in, there's no problem because I know where they are there. Now, there's printing on my pages, so I have to make sure that I'm going the right direction, either by my charm pick that's supposed to be on top, or if you're not, that I see where it is, because I don't want to put the inside backwards. So now all I'm going to do is put adhesive and add these inside, and I will be right back. Okay, so now I'm adding my last strip of adhesive. You can put as much as never too much. So when you add it on, add it as close to the edge as you can to keep your paper from rolling. And now I'm going to take my paper, double checking again. See, now I'm backwards because I was working at it. So checking to make sure my paper's right, this paper's right. And now I'm going to align this right at the edge of this side here. And just push it through. And if you align it right, you should not have any loose edges. It should come up really, really straight. But don't worry about it, because you can always cut it off after. We are going to dress this particular paper also. Whoops. Well, this is not necessarily a good thing, because this glue is so, so hard. Once you put it on, it really, really sticks. So now all I do is I see how it does a nice seam in the center here. So when you're gluing your book, everything is going to be really nice and retrofitted. So, like that. And like that. Okay. So now that I have my holes, I am going to puncture them through because I know where they are. And I am going to put my brads in there. So now I have an inside that's done, an outside that's done, and let me fit my brads in there, and I will be right back. You'd like to see, thought maybe you'd like to see how I do my brads. So I will take some from here. Let's see here. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, whoops, not yellow. You can put whatever color you want, but I'm just going to, so it's gray or yellow or white. I think that's gray. I wonder if I have enough weights. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 1 is 7. There you go. Here's my eyelets. What did I call them? Brads? They're eyelets. And I'm going to push them in to my top here. Now I need to change my setting on this, like so, and I'm going to add it in. I'm going to start from the top. I'm going to put my brad in that little hole. This is an We Are Memory Keeper, And all you do is you push in. You don't have to push. Oh, I put it backwards. Well, wouldn't you know it? So I'll have to take that one off. I will take it off later. See, I wasn't paying attention. That's the back. I want to put it in the front. So, can't do it now, but I will, whoops, I'll take it out and I will put it back. That's not a problem at all. So that's all you do is, because I'm using We Are Memory Keepers brads, they match, they fit perfectly. Although I don't only use theirs, I do buy them separately also. But once you get used to it, you can adjust your settings in order to make it work. And there's not a problem. See how pretty that makes it? I like it. I do. Anyway. And you're still wondering about that white line? Not to worry. We are going to get that all prettied up later. Not sure yet what I'm going to do there. I'm kind of a person that, I've said this before, I work on a fly. Like, I have an idea, but then when it comes to embellishments and stuff, I kind of do it on a fly. In other words, I will, oh, I think this will look good. Or let me try that. Sometime I tear it apart. There you go. It's starting to get together, guys. It's starting to fall into a plan. Now, we're going to insert, before we go any further, we're going to insert our books. So then you have to decide which one you want to go first. Do you want this one to go first? Do you want that one to go first? That's entirely up to you. I'm probably going to put this one first. I have no idea why, but I am. So I'm going to get my thread out again. Same thread I had when I started, which is my little DMC here, floss. And I'm going to cut myself a piece. I'm going to add it to my wide head needle. As you can tell, this is a, whoops, where's my camera here? There you go. This is quite a large needle. I'm not quite into these kind of sewing, so I'm not sure where they come from. I believe this one here, I took it out of my sewing box from my grandmother's, I believe. Oh, I have such a hard time threading this. I have a little machine, but I didn't pull it up. There you go. Good thing it's got a big head. If it was a normal needle, I'd never be able to put it together. I'll go back to my center of my book. Okay, so the center of my book is, let me see, there. Now, I'm going to sew this in exactly the same way as I sewed my signature. So I start by the center hole, which I have covered here. Let me see, right here. I don't see it here. There you go, that's where it is. There, I could find the hole on this thing. Okay, so then I just run it through. It's as easy as that. There you go. It's easy as that. Okay. Now, I don't have to put paper clips on this because, not paper clips, but binding clips, because it's already binded, so the paper is not going to go all over the place. Now, I'm going to, now that I have gone through, but if you want to take this piece and add it on a clip, one handy here. Yeah, I'll just use this big one. Same idea. Then that's fine. Just pull it over to the side here and let it hold it. That way there, it will go, it won't play tricks on you, and you'll have it binded and say, see that you've got the end is gone. So now I'm going to run it into this hole, the center hole, pull it back into this hole here, like that. And I pulled it out of my needle here, so bear with me. I know this is going to be a bit of a long video, but it's because we're doing it really from scratch. And that is for the ones who have never done a journal before. But if you have, you can jump from section to section. and just go where you want to. That is the fun thing. Always remember to put your journal on the right side of your cover. I've done it. Finished it, opened it up. I had my inserts reversed to the cover, upside down. So I had to take it all out and put it back in. And it's not exactly what you want to do. Let's just say I was a bit annoyed, just a little bit. When you're using your thread, as I mentioned before, always, always make sure that your thread is very strong, because you don't want to have to tie a knot in here and it's all going to let go, you know, in your binding and so forth. So make sure that if you're using fishing line or jewelry line or something, it's very tuggable. What I mean by that is that it's very, very easy to manipulate and pull and tug. It doesn't have to be I did exactly what I said not to do. Let me go back on camera, off camera, and rethread this for you. Okay, so now we're right back where I left you. So I was pulling on this string instead of this one. So this is now, my binding is all done. So now I am going to knot it for it not to slip. And all you do for that is I have never been taught how to slip a knot, but I'm not sure, but I just tie it one way, and then I put my rope through the other way, and it just seems to work for me. It's really nice and tight. So now I just add a few extra knots for safety measures. And again, I'll let my threads fall to see until I decide for sure that's what I want. And see how tight it is? See how nice and firm that is right there? And it's on the right side. And this is how it shows in the back. Okay? So I'm going to do the other one. And if you want to follow along, it's fine. We're going to do it again. I might leave the camera running just to see, so you can see. It's a little trickier to put the second one in because you're working against this, but really it's not. And to for my first experience of putting the signatures in after, it's really easy to thread in. I guess alert was, is it going to be easy to run the needle through and once it's embellished and etc. But you know what? It ran in like butter. It was really simple. So let me find my center again. It's right here. And I'm going to put my needle through. Just to make sure I'm on the center hole here. Some of you are not sure. There you go. There you go. And again, making sure that I have a tail. And if you want to, you can secure it like this, so it won't be gone on you. It won't pull it through. So I'm going to start by the center hole. I'm just going to pull this in. Now, another thing that I found that was handy too is when I was working to put the second one in, I took this big clamp, as a matter of fact, and I just held my binder down, sliding on the, like that. I just found it easy to work that way. Now, if you don't have that, that's fine. It's still going to work, but it keeps the book down because the book is new, the signature is new, and being that it's new, it's a little bit... It hasn't been open shut, so it's a little fluffy. And when I put my needle through, guys, look, it's going right through. So it's like, I'm telling you, it's like butter. Okay, I didn't secure my rope here, but I'm being very careful. And you're putting it through, it's going to go through that hole again, like so. It's really simple. Like you can do this, so it's so simple to do. And last but not least, I'm going to run it through my third hole and through the third hole journal, which is right here, like that. See how simple it is? That's it. Now all I need to do is again tie a knot and tie it as snug as I can, because you want the book to be firm into its into the thing. I'm gonna have to do this again. All right, so I'm done putting the signatures in. I have no idea how I managed that one, but not only did I broke the rope, which is the first time, I lost my needle. Could I've absolutely gone through this room, this table, everywhere. I even swept, cannot find my needle. So I had to go and get another needle from my grandmother, who's passed away many years ago. This is her needles, and there's the one with the big heads on them, so I had to go get another one. But anyway, the point being, I'm done. Just baffles me. I'll find it, I hope. I'd love to find it back. But anyway, this is the journal so far. So as we open it up, you can tell this is how it goes. So right now, what we're going to do is we're going to embellish the front. And how we're going to do that is by adding some embellishments. Hi again. All right, so when we finished the journal, I said we were going to start working on the cover. So we have all the inserts done. And we might be adding more. I may add more before it's gone. I'm not too sure. So this is what I did to coincide with what was inside. And I'm going to continue working, but I'm not guaranteed that I won't add something else as the time progresses. But for now, I'm going to tell you what I've done to this journal. So let me try to take some of the glare off. What I did is I cut out a stove that she had on one of the cards, on one of her retro cards, and an apron from one of the retro cards. And then I cut out a lady from one of the cards that she had, and I'm not quite sure which one it was, but I cut that one out. And then I made that one, I put some dimensionals underneath, so it is lifted, as you can tell. See how it's not the same as this here? So it gives it some dimension. When you look at it straight in or look at the book live, you can tell, and it she just gives it more give. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do here yet, if I'm going to do something. But I put some rickrack on the side, and I added some bling here. And on here it was just little cutaways. And what I did with these cutaways, including the center piece here, is I added some glossy Mod Podge, and it has a bit of sparkles inside, but it's gonna like this here is gonna clear just like that. It's just that I did it a few hours ago, so it takes a while to get totally clear, and it gives it just a bit of oomph, I guess is what I'm trying to say. And for the center here, I just took a picture again off one of these. I'm not even sure which one it was now, but it doesn't matter. And I took my scallop punch, which I believe I've put away again, but my scallop punch, and I just cut out a piece around her, and I added her down. I thought she fit well the center here. Around here is a doily that I glued on, and I just added some little flower rhinestones going around here. Now the letters, what I did, I cut each individual letter separate, and they are like this, and it's something that I have, a set that I have, and they come from China. But I cut the word sassy three times in the black, just a regular cardstock. Actually, it was leftover pieces that I have. It wouldn't matter if what color it was. And one last, the top piece here, which would be the fourth piece, is cut out from the aluminum foil type of papers that I got at the dollar store. So that's what that is. that I got at the dollar store. So they cut out beautifully. So what I wanted, I didn't want the letters to be flat on here. I wanted a little bit of lift without putting some dimensions. So I just glued it with a pen. I used this is the one that I used right here, actually. It's the two-way glue from Zig. And all I did was go around the letters, put a piece on, a little bit, you know, and I stacked it like a sandwich. And it came out really nice. And I don't know if you can see there, they're just a little lifted. Not too much, but because I used all black, it kind of gives it some back, a little bit of lift and a little bit of shadow. I really like it. So the side, all I did to this to date is I added two pieces of that rickrack because I use it inside the binder too, so I thought it would tie in together. I'm not quite sure what else I'm going to do, but I added some bling to this, and that's where I am at this point on the cover. Now, I want to work inside the cover. I want to do the inside here, and I thought I would share with you and make it live so you could see what I'm doing to add in that page. I am taking, let me put this aside, but you are going to need plain cardstock and a colored cardstock or a color pattern piece of paper. Now what I have done in this case is clear off my room here. I've taken a piece of cardstock that I had in this color, which goes extremely well with that, color coordinated, and I printed out a piece of paper from the collection that I have from her. Then I took and cut one piece of cardstock, the regular cardstock. I cut it 5.5 by 11, and the colored paper, I cut it 5.5 by 11. Okay, 5.5 by 11. So now I took my scoreboard, and this is what you're going to do with the scoreboard. You're going to take this particular piece of cardstock, and you're going to score it at 2 3/4, 2 3/4 all the way down. You're going to take it and flip it and go back at 2 3/4. Then you're going to fold it like when we make a card. If some of you make cards, you know how you make a gatefold for the center. A gatefold means that you close it from the center and you go from there. But so this is what you have. Okay, this is going to be the base for my card. Then you take the pattern paper, and which is the same size as the cardstock that I just cut up, and you take it and score it down to 2 3/4 here, flip it over, and you score it again at 2 3/4 here. Okay? That's it. That's all you need for that. 2 3/4, 2 3/4 on each end of both piece of cardstock, which are the bigger pieces, the only big piece you're going to need, which is 5.5 by 11. So now you have two score lines. So you're going to take these, the two, and you're going to bend it backwards like this. Okay? So where the 2.5 inch, not the cardstock, but the pattern paper, you want to bend it down like this. Okay? Now, I did one side for purpose of going quicker. You're going to take your piece of paper and you're going to put a pencil mark at the center here, which is 5.5 inches, and another pencil mark here at 5.5 inches as a guideline. Then you're going to take your paper or cardstock, whatever you have, and you're going to bring it down, but you need to meet this corner at the point. And if your measurements are right, it should match up totally. I can see my pencil mark there. I think that's the closest I can get the camera for you to see. You see? Yeah, pretty much. But there's my pencil mark, and there it is. So all I do is you just fold it down. If you have cardstock, make sure you burnish it right. Okay? Now that's both folded that way. Now I'm going to take this piece, And I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So you use both corners and you fold it down in a triangle like this. But you have to make sure that your triangle, that point right here, starts right at the point. And if you match your sides, you should have no issues at all. And that ends up being like that. Okay? So you have one going this way, or you can do both like that. And then you turn around and you can do both the other way if you wish. Now, if you've done it and followed me the way I do it, when you open it up, it's going to look like this. All right? And then with your measurements, which I did not do this correctly, back up here, I went to 2 2 2 3/4, and it should be 2 2 3/4, 2 3/4, I went 1 3/4, so I'm going to score this back. That's my fault, guys. So once you're done, and you've done the both ends at 2 3/4, you're going to end up, and you've folded it backwards, like so. I'm not worried about this here, but so I'm going to fold it on the score mark back here. Then I've done all my folds here, like that. It should automatically come out to a fold when you open it up. This should automatically come in this way, okay? So if you pull it inside like that and you bring it down, this is what you're going to have. Oops. This is what you're going to have. You're going to have this piece here. Okay? And it should be square. Then you're going to start embellishing it. So you can do whatever you want. If you want to start embellishing it from the beginning, you open this up and you can do all your embellishments inside. You can also use a two-sided color paper. You don't have to use white. So this is going to fold like this. Like this. Okay? And then you're going to take this and glue it down in here. And I'm going to do it to show you guys exactly what I mean. So I'm going to glue it down. And you can put more adhesive if you wish. And you're going to make sure that it's aligned in the center of your card. If you have to take a measurement, take the time to take a measurement. And all that is when I mean a measurement, is take a ruler, bring it across. We know that this is 5.5 across. So 5.5 is 2 3/4. So we know that 2 3/4 is the corner right here. So 1 1.5 2 3/4 is right here. So that's the center of that. So I'm going to put my point right here, and I'm going to center my point here like that, and my point should automatically, everything should align. Okay? And then the line should be horizontal, not vertical. Here. Okay, so there's the line. It should be towards you. Okay? The line, I put it this way by ear. Make it come towards you. I've never done these, so this is my first time that I'm doing this pocket. Although that, even if I had done it a half a dozen times, I can still, not paying attention, can make that mistake. Okay, so you see what I got? So this is what you end up with. And it's, the opening is up and down, okay? Now I'm going to put some glue on here, okay? So I'm going to address this all with adhesive. Like this. I'm telling you, this is good glue, Scotch glue. All right, so tape. Now I'm going to shut this flap down. Now I'm going to put down this flap, and everything should align perfectly. And if it doesn't, because you've played with it too much like I have, just make sure that all is covered like this. Perfect. So now, when you open it, this is what you have. Okay? So you can do different things from here. You can, knowing what I've done, I will do it on the colored side instead of keeping the inside white, but that's my error. I have another piece. I'm going to do it again. But this is what I'm going to do, and I'm going to embellish all the top here, and then I'm going to take my journal and then put it all together and get back to you. So, okay, so as I was getting ready to do the next part, I realized how long this video was going to be. So I am not going to show you how I made every paper clip and so forth, every dangle, which is the only thing that I added after because of the time limit. You can watch my other videos where I show how I make different paper clips and so forth, but I will show you how I finished off that envelope that we did, that little opening card. What I did is I added some bling, and I added some just a card and some more retro bits and pieces that I have, and I have cut it, and it closes perfectly. I added two cards here saying one sassy retro, which to me is the name of, couldn't be better for the name of the journal, and I just added a little tie like this. There's room for it, so why not? I've added the two ties to close the journal, and I just added a on each side these little clips with the flowers. On the side, I've added a chain, like a dangle chain, and I've added all these little charms that I've made. This little book I made with polymer clay, and you know, this is just a paper clip that looks like glasses. This one here is beautiful. It's a flower and a leaf that a friend of mine that I've done a swap with, she made, which is a talent that I can never develop. I just can't do it. Anyway, a whole bunch of charms, and that fits the theme of this journal. And on the side here, you'll see a whole bunch of dangle paper clips that I've made. These are all handmade by me, and they're so simple, and they're all like this, very easy to make, and it just dresses it up. And that is the journal for the Sassy Retro Journal. I just love the way this sparkles. I just think if you turn it, it'll go to the light source that you have. I want to thank Elizabeth Wood to have supplied me and with all of those printouts that I've made. You can have exactly the same thing as what I have. It's all available in her Etsy shop at Retro Sass Design. I will put it at the beginning of the video where you can contact her. And I thank her very much to having faith in me to be able to do one of these with her printouts. And it's been a true treasure to make these, to make this journal. This is beyond my comfort zone because I am more of a vintage person, really vintage with lace and so forth. But I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. I know it's a little long, but every part I hope was explained for you to be able to go and make it on your own without second guessing yourself. Have yourself a wonderful creative day, and we hope to see you real soon. This is Yvonne signing off. Bye-bye.